Hey everyone, and welcome to another daily video from Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle. My name is Ricky Hayes, and in today's video, we're going into two simple methods to find out about where your competitors are getting their traffic sources from, and then you can basically model that, all right? So let's get straight into it. So, understanding where people get their traffic from is a very important way to then basically go back and then utilize that to sort of understand, well, if I market there and I take some of that audience, then I'm likely to get some of these sales, okay? So it's very important that, and they're two simple and free ways. Actually, I'm gonna put that in the title, sounds better. Anyway, of doing that. So I just jumped on my alternative Facebook account and I just put get yours here, and of course come up with a whole heap of, you know, these viral products. And you can see that was cool, is a, I believe, a large Facebook page, which it is. And this works really well when they're using a Bitly URL. A lot of people used to use Google shortener links. Not really anymore, because Google changed a lot of things, and now people are trying to hide where they're getting their traffic from by making it so that their shortened URL is, you know, you can actually use another piece of software so that people can't actually see it. But a lot of people still use the Bitly, so it's an easy way. So what you do, right, it's as simple as this, is you copy the link, right, put it in your browser. I've already done it here, but I'll do it again just for the sake of showing you and highlighting it. And that's it. You put a plus on the end and you can see then the traffic sources. So what we can actually see from here is that this product went viral for a period of time. There can be a lot of reasons, of course. Obviously, they were doing paid marketing. I presume that they're probably paying to have it on some large Facebook pages and that as well. But you can see that all here, and you can see that, you know, this is their website. See the full URL, the world's most comfortable full body pillow, okay? So what we can see from this that's really important is the referrers. So we can see that they haven't really done much on Instagram. Now, what that means in many regards is that's an opportunity, okay? That means that on Instagram, you actually have opportunity. What it does mean also is that email, SMS, and direct, I suspect that's probably email, and direct, as just an educated guess, and obviously Facebook. So they're likely to be, well, they're definitely doing Facebook marketing, as well as they're probably promoting it on some other pages. You know how there's this current trend now where they're putting it as like an episode to try and make it seem more unique when it's a load of shit. But anyway, and you can then see as well the top referring countries. Now, again, you can straight away see United States, United Kingdom, Canada, and 97 more. You can't click it, which is annoying. I think you have to have a pro account for it or something. But anyway, but I should also add that in order to see this, you have to just make a free Bitly account, okay? Just make a free Bitly account to connect to Facebook, whatever. It takes 5 seconds and you can see this info. You can see from here that this product has gone from, you know, absolutely insane clicks on the September the 10th, you know, we're now, what's the date? I don't even know what the date is, whatever. To, you know, thousands of clicks to now down to nothing by the looks of it. So it's highly likely that they've stopped marketing this product because it stopped being profitable. So it looked like it really got some traction because they were doing some heavy marketing in the space of a week, really, just over a week. But what you can see is this is really important, is that this graph can actually tell you, let's say if it was the opposite way, let's say it's around here that it's going up, then you know that that's also partly a trending product. Okay, the product is trending. And then you can see what the sources are and the top sources, and then you can see what countries. And having that is really important because now you have the audience, because you can, these are the people. So straight away, you know, what I can see here is what are the most of the comments, okay? Most of the comments are women, okay? So we now know three things about this product. If it was hypothetically like a trending product, so if it was a trending product, like like it was at that point, then we'd know, okay, well, it's trending. We know that Facebook is converting very well. We also know that United States is very interested, and we know it's women, okay? So those are four things you can find just from simply copying the bit.ly URL and putting a plus on the end, and then having a look at the comments. And there you go. You know, that's product research 101, not hard at all. The other thing is then you actually go to the website. Now, I actually noticed, and I have no idea, they're using the same app that I am. Sorry, I just went blank there. When you scroll down, it has this. But anyway, so for starters, I've seen this website a few times. I'm not a big fan of how they have this layout. I think it could be better. Huh, they're selling one of my winners. Anyway, from ages ago. But one of the funniest things, have a look at this, is how the fuck they have 7 pixels. Now, I can only assume that they're doing heavy amounts of retargeting via apps, which is a blatant waste of money. So, like, they've got FB few. But anyway, I don't recommend this. If you see this, I don't know why they're doing this in this fashion and if this works. But it's almost like they have multiple pixels that they're doing for different things. And I don't understand why. I've never seen so many being picked up. But anyway, what I was getting at with this is that the other part that you can do is an app called SimilarWeb, okay? And it's free. SimilarWeb is a fantastic free app. Chrome extension. Then there's also Commerce Inspector. So I've been using SimilarWeb a lot more, and it's just awesome. Okay, so you can tell a few things from this, okay? You can, actually a lot of things, and it's really powerful. Estimated visits, 322K. So you can see that they've gotten a lot of traffic, so they paid a lot of money. You can see that they're ranked quite high, especially in the United States. And actually on the global scale, they're ranked quite high because they're paying for a lot of traffic. Their bounce rate as a whole is 67.19%. Now, to give that an idea, you probably want to aim for around 50 to 60%. So that's as a whole. Have a look in your Google Analytics for that. What's also important is you get a bit more of a granular look into their overall traffic. Okay, so we can see from the bit.ly URL where the traffic sources were coming from, and we can also see on just the store where the actual traffic sources are coming from. So we can see here that it's direct and that it's social. So what that means, most likely, so search is SEO, mail is mail, display is the Google Display Network, links is just links. Direct is people, mainly half the time, I believe that's attributed to people that know the website and have put it basically straight into their browser to browse the website, okay? So it's a combination of mail and just directly going to the website. It's a tough one. Again, you have to look in your Google Analytics. But anyway, you can tell from that, so that you can tell that they're building their brand. And in their case, it's a general store. I personally think that they're doing heavy upsells, frequently bought together, all that, but I just don't like it. But the social, so you can obviously see that straight away that most of their traffic source is social, okay? And I can actually say with confidence, I reckon, that most of the people that are direct are probably return customers in that, and that it's just attributed that downwards, okay? The other thing that you can then tell, and this is all free, this is what's amazing about this app, there is a premium version, I believe, as well, which then you have, you can check apps and stuff too if you wanted to pay for it, which is cool. Anyway, but again, you can see straight away that 50% of their overall traffic is from the United States, okay? And then you get a huge drop in the other countries. So they're not really targeting many other countries other than the United States. You can actually see here, Netherlands seems to really like this product, which is random. But anyway, but you can see that. So you can see that United States really like this. It's actually quite saturated in the last 3 months. You can see that in the same in Canada. But you can see they haven't really targeted Europe. This would be a very good region to target. Australia or New Zealand, okay? A lot of people never target New Zealand, and I don't understand why. But it's a country that buys a lot. I know a lot of people from New Zealand. They have deep pockets, and there's nothing wrong with that. So you can see just from that as well, I've got a better idea of this as well. So now we definitely know that United States obviously is a high converting country, especially for this store. So we can also see here is top referring sites. So referring sites are, it tracks it differently, but you can see here track China Post. So they're definitely a dropshipping store. So you can tell that they're dropshipping. A lot of these stores end up branding their product, but then, pardon me, but then you can see that and you can tell that they're definitely dropshipping. I don't know what that is. I can't remember. But that's a that's Commerce Inspector. And these are spying people spying on them for their product research to then try and sell them on their product research tool. You can see here their organic keywords. So this would correlate directly back to direct. Okay, so we can see that people are looking for Wooksify, all right, and that is the bulk of their traffic, and that will be what will be mainly the direct, all right. And so you can tell that they're not really doing any paid keywords. Okay, so what that means is they're not doing Google Shopping, they're not doing Google Ads, they're not doing Bing Ads, they're not doing any of that. Okay, and you know, that's on them. A lot of people aren't doing Google Ads. I'm doing a lot more Google Ads now because it is very untapped and a very profitable form of income. Okay, and again, you can see here, now you sort of get a nice bar graph. You can see for some reason that I presume they've got uploaded on YouTube, they've got a tiny amount of traffic that comes from there, but the majority is their Facebook, okay? So they don't even probably have an Instagram page by the looks of it, really. That it's probably they've got a large following, I believe, on Facebook, and that's where a lot of their traffic source is coming from. Sorry, let me just reopen this. Again, you can see ads. So you can see that their top publishers, looks like it's livenewson.com and GoLikes. They're probably paying these people. And top ad networks, Cradio, Taboola, and Outbrain. I've never used any of them. Anyway, and you can also tell their audience interests. So very similar, okay? And so you can see just from two simple things that are completely free, a Chrome extension and just a bit.ly URL, how much you understand about a store, how much you then understand about your audience, and how much opportunity then you can make from this. And then you use Commerce Inspector to look at their apps as well, because then you don't have to use the paid version of this, because in Commerce Inspector you can use that and look at their apps, and then you can have a look at their app. Now, just further to this as well, I should add, this is Brooklyn. You can tell it's Brooklyn, one of my favorite themes. I don't know why they have the add to cart and then buy it now. I don't know. I find that weird. They don't have any reviews on this, even though it's a product that's had a lot of reviews. A lot of traffic apparently. So I'm not sure what's going on there. You can see, you know, like that. I'm just having a whinge now, but you can see that their website just no. Like if I go add to cart. Okay, so as I said, they're using the same type of thing as me. They're using Shopify Pay. They're not using Stripe. Really, they should be using Stripe. The blah 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 checkout. I presume that's obvious because they are paying tax. They got the sale thing. There, you know, you may like, but they should be doing a lot more upsells. They should be doing an in-cart upsell. This just really annoys me when I look at this from such a large store. And you know, you can see why the fuck did they change their cart? It looks stupid. Decided to take off all the trust badges and just purely have a timer, and then they have all these form of pay. You know, they should be like, why don't they have the actual logo there? Like, god damn it, fucking annoys me. But anyway, so I'm gonna stop bantering. I don't know why I did that live, but whenever I look at these stores, I'm like, what the fuck are you people thinking? But you can see as well, so now you understand technically three different ways to understand, completely break down a store completely for free in 5 minutes realistically, as well as then you can get a lot of ideas on what they're doing, what they could be doing better, and why you're doing it better, and a lot more from it. And it really didn't take me long. I literally typed in Facebook, get yours here, as you can see up on the top there, and that's all I did, all right? So look guys, I hope that has been helpful. If it has been helpful for you, don't forget to drop a like, hit a comment down below if you do have any questions. Subscribe for updates. I do 2 or 3 videos a week, just very busy. And don't forget to hit the notification bell so you're updated as soon as I upload a video, okay? Don't forget to join my group on Facebook, Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle, completely free. There's a cheat sheet down below. Just open that up. It'll guide you through. You get a free cheat sheet, helps you get started. I have heaps of other videos, okay guys, that you can watch. I've made a number of playlists there for you, Facebook mini course, product research on multiple platforms. I can't even remember because off the top of my head, I'm really crap. But as well, I am expanding my services, which I'll be announcing over the coming weeks. But if you are interested in my premium support, where a lot of people in that, well, pretty much everyone in that group, I should say, really bad marketing pitch, but whatever, I'm going to go with it, are seeing huge success. Within a week, people are seeing a major turnover just because they're asking questions, we're answering, and they're seeing that result. So if you do want to start kicking goals today rather than tomorrow, and you don't want to spend $1 billion, then join my group, Gold Class, on Facebook, okay? There's a link down below. It is a paid group, okay? You know, you have to pay to get in, because obviously I put a lot of time into this, so you get a lot of value from it, all right? So look, aside from that, I hope today's video has been helpful. Thank you very much. For-